Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition. This is Hill with yet another episode. And we are here at the Windhelm Stables. We're about to do another main mission here, A Night to Remember. I have awoken from a night of debauchery with no idea what happened. Sam and the staff he promised me have disappeared. Isolde, hope I'm not butchering that too badly, in Whiterun has told me to look for Sam in Morvanskar. So that's what we're going to do here, folks. And it looks like Morvanskar is this way. I'm not really sure what happened here. What's going on?
I'm sure the boot in your arse will take your mind off your troubles.
Okay, I guess everything's okay. Not sure what happened. I remember challenging Sam in the bar. Oh, here we go. To a drinking contest and... And not much else after that. I think I woke up in a different city and... There'd been damage done to a... I don't know. I mean, you know, I really don't know. I was drunk, so that's my excuse. So, one of the other things to let you guys know about is I removed a lighting mod, the realistic lighting overhaul, because it was pretty much hit or miss. You know, some of the areas were just like too dark. And, you know, I'm looking at the videos on YouTube, and you can't see anything. And even when I'm recording, I can barely see stuff. But, you know, sometimes, you know, the lighting looks spectacular in some areas. But other times, it's too dark. Or we were getting that ridiculous and overwhelming glare. So what I've done is turned off the lighting overhaul. And this is just the natural Skyrim lighting. So we'll see how this works out for now. I may or may not try to install a different mod to improve the lighting, but that's where we are. I kind of think this looks better already. But I want to get this mission out of the way because every time I go to Whiterun, Isolde, or whatever her name is, keeps on saying that I owe her money or something, so I don't like being in somebody's debt like that, and especially since I don't even know what the hell happened. So let's just get this. Okay, here we are, Morvanskar. Uh-oh, looks like enemies are here too. Uh-oh, ice mages. It looks like I'm going to leave the horse over here. Oh, look at them running all up here. Jesus, you better leave my horse alone. You need to get back. Let me handle this. Damn it, my shout is depleted. You see this where I keep slaying three people in a row, and this is a mod that I've added. It adds more abilities to the different races in Skyrim. This is for the Redguard. I think the mod is called Imperial Races. So by doing this and unlocking I guess by killing people, I'm unlocking an ability. I believe it will slow down time and aid me in combat. So, you know, that's pretty cool. I'm looking forward to seeing that unlocked. But I'm looking here. It looks like we could probably darken the game a little bit because everything looks kind of gray and washed out. But I'll probably work with that off camera, not while I'm recording. But I think this will work a lot better for YouTube. That's the problem. I mean, I hate, you know, that you guys can't see stuff. And I hate that I can't see it either. and it's actually easier for me to see it than you guys, but if when we both can't see it, there's a problem. And I'm referring to Sadia and talking to her in her little room area there in the Bannered Mare. It was just too dark, way too dark. Let me do a save here, because again, you never know how things could quickly go south. And we are playing. We have increased the difficulty to, I believe they call it expert. It's the level above adept. So, it is a little bit more difficult. I died once in the last video. So, I do have to be careful. I am not invincible. Even with the abilities of Tall Papa. Not invincible. And, you know, here's my plug to have you guys check out the backstory in the description. It's, the link is down there. It's not a link, but in the description there's the backstory on how this character is the way he is, how he has more abilities and perks and whatnot than the normal Redguard male due to a melding of him and a Yokudan deity. So that's my build, and I'm sticking to it. Alright, let's keep going and see what the heck. Look at this. Look at the light coming from here. It's almost like a trap.
Why do they need me to do this? We use magic.
What was that?
Uh-oh, they already see us. Oh, girl, you go.
That takes care of that.
And I really need some health potions. Need to learn how to make them, too. Increased in my smithing. Yeah, iron. And see, I can't recall because I did delete a lot of the magic stuff. The apocalypse magic and the ordinator perks. I don't know if I can still transmute iron to silver or gold. I don't think I can anymore. I do miss some of those abilities, though, I have to admit. Alright, this is looking better, because I think with the lighting overhaul, this would be, you know, very heavily glaring with light and stuff. I think this is better. But I still... Uh-oh, it's barred from the other side. I still may want to, you know, install another lighting mod, but so far, so good. Alright, looks like there's nothing else through here. So we're going to have to go down these stairs. I think what this light up here is trying to tell me that's where I need to go. Saving again. But so far so good. Visibility down here in this dungeon is decent. I think this will look adequate on YouTube. So we may just leave it like this. We'll see.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, and if you got a bad feeling, then something's about to go down. All right, let's go. This stuff over here.
Looks like we're getting close. We got the big mar- Oh, look. In the mod that I'm using, the wearable lanterns, when you go into sneak mode, the lantern will go off automatically. And it's configurable if you want it to stay on all the time. You know, you can do that. You can have it manual. Turn it off and on. But this...
Shit, how'd you see me?
So yeah, on this expert difficulty, you can see that these enemies pack a punch and they are no joke. It's healing hand so I can heal my companion. That's the other thing I miss with the ordinator perks. I had a perk where I could eat any of these items and I would immediately know all four of their attributes. I think it's four, it might be more than that, but yeah, just eating one thing. That's good. I would know all of them and I miss that. So there are some good things about ordinator. Look at this, a beehusk hive. Yeah, it's four things, but right now, you know, like you see here, I think when I had the perk on this Hagraven feathers, I ate one and I immediately knew all four of its abilities. I'm hoping in this vanilla version that they do have that in the alchemy tree when I eventually unlock it. Let's hope. All right. Definitely needed that healing potion. Okay, I don't see anything else here. I think we can move on. I'm just checking for potions and books that might level up my character. What the hell? What was that? What the hell? What's going on? Let's do a save. Alright, it looks like I gotta go over. Oh my god, it's gonna teleport me somewhere. Okay. Well, there is a chest here. Let me grab this first. Amulet of Julianos. Okay, we'll just take everything. Whatever we can't use, we'll sell. I'm gonna save this again. All right, here we go, Misty Grove.
Oh.
Wow.
This place don't look natural.
Uh-oh. Oh, okay. Are these people friendly?
You're here. I was beginning to think you might not make it.
You were expecting me? What the hell?
You're here. I was beginning to think you might not make it.
It was quite a trip. Where are we?
I thought you might not remember your first trip here. You had a big night. I think you've definitely earned the staff.
I have all the things needed to repair it.
Oh, the Hagraven feather and so on. You can throw all those out. You see, I really just needed something to encourage you to go out into the world and spread merriment.
What the hell?
Yes?
Who are you?
I am Sanguine, Daedric Prince of Debauchery.
Oh, I should have known. Damn it.
I know. How could I lie to you? Well, how could I trust you until we've shared a few drinks? But it wasn't long before I realized you'd make a more interesting bearer of my not-quite-holy staff than this waste of flesh.
Why did you choose me?
Let's be honest here. I don't always think my decisions through, but you're going places. Maybe a little influence from your old Uncle Sanguine could help adjust your course a bit.
Thanks, I guess.
My pleasure. But I think it's time for you to go. No fun keeping you locked up in here with the staff.
So that was it?
Come on in. Let me know if you need anything, or take a seat by the fire, and I'll send someone over.
Where are we? We're back at the Bannered Mare. This is where it all started. Sam was sitting right here in this chair, and we started drinking. And then all that stuff started happening.
I guess that completed the mission. Wow. Okay.
I'm right behind you.
All right, well, let's, I guess we're leaving. Hold on, let me just check something out. Let's go up here to Sadia's room that was just too dark when I had that lighting mod installed.
Don't mind me.
Oh, yeah, you can see now. That's too bad. I mean, I like that mod, but it's too dark. Too dark. Okay, I think we're just going to go with the natural Skyrim lighting. I think they did a decent enough job that I can just leave it as it is. Some people were complaining that, oh, when they remastered the game and stuff, they didn't do a good job with the lighting. But, hey, it's working for me. I can see. That's the most important thing. All right. Let's see. I guess we can do Blessings of Nature. Going. Oh, you're kidding me. Way over here? Orphan Rock. So, looks like we got to go to Helgen. That's the closest place. Your familiar is always attacking me. We gotta put a stop to that. Okay, look, here comes somebody running down here like a fool.
bodies just in case. Somebody might be carrying something interesting. Okay, so this is where the, what the? This is where we're supposed to be. What's here? Oh shit! Who is that?
It's a little late giving me the achievement for killing three people. But hey, I'm getting closer. Anything to disenchant? Executioner's Iron Sword. Yeah, let me learn that.
What's on your mind?
Let me learn this.
What can I do for you?
Down the shouts, let's learn that.
What's on your mind?
Alright, should be good.
I'm right behind you.
Oh, a chest.
Friggin' sap.
I'm right behind you.
Uh-oh, something else is out here. Let me pick up these flowers, though. What the heck? Oh, shit. Alright. Let's get down from here. He's a witch. What the hell? A trap. North Skybound Watch.
Here we go.
What can I do for you?
I got a sky shard out here, but unfortunately, since I removed the ordinator perks, I have an overabundance of perks right now. So I don't need to pick up anything else.
I've never seen anything quite like that.
Uh-oh. Let me save. It's not activating. Okay, well, maybe it's part of a quest. Oh, wait, here's a door. Missed it.
Huh?
Uh-oh. Looks like somebody's sitting down here.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
I'm glad you don't turn on me, though, for hitting you.
Looks like some nice armor, and it's expensive too. Look at this. Ooh, nice. We'll sell that shield.
What can I do for you?
Here's a little trap here. Please, don't push.
Oh.
Don't push me, girl. It's a trap. Come on.
Well, we still got the glare. So it's not exactly the mod that was causing it. Nice. If you thought you couldn't see with the mod, it was too dark. Look at it without the mod. Look at this. It's as bright as beep. Oh, hell. is that? So this is a Stormcloak person that is unloyal. I guess, whatever. Another quick save and let's keep going. Looks like that's it. And it's daytime now too, good. I guess let me go up these stairs here just in case. Some amazing treasure. Yep, look at this. There's a chest. Alright, I'm not liking this music. What is this? Oh, fuck. Really? Stuck up here. I'm gonna have to fight from here. If that thing comes back.
You'll die this day, dragon.
All right, let's go. Come on. Fighting a mage.
something. What are you? A wisp.
Alright, let's see. Where do we need to go from here? Okay, back to Whiterun to complete this mission. See, again, we got distracted. But we were helping out. I don't remember her name. Let's put our weapons away.
Rorikstead's nice enough to do that.
Someone who can get things done. I like that.
What is it? What has happened to the Gilda Green? I have traveled long here to worship.
Now, this is much better here, inside here. You can really see clearly, but I am going to make some adjustments, though. I think we can turn down some of the brightness. All right, Danica Pure Spring. I never would have...
It's disgraceful.
Let me get some blessings just in case I picked up any diseases while I was out there.
But this is supposed to be your work.
So, have you gotten Nettlebane back from those filthy hagravens yet?
Yeah, I got it right here.
Oh, I honestly didn't expect you to come back. Of course, I'm glad you did. Now,
don't sound like it.
I don't really want to touch that thing, though. Do you think you could handle the next steps?
You mean there's more? What needs to be done now?
Eldergleam Sanctuary Grove is to the east of here. You can use Nettlebane to retrieve some of its sap.
Was I correct in hearing that you were traveling to the Grove of the Eldergleam?
Oh, Lord. Can I help you?
A pilgrim. I follow the voice of Kinnereth wherever it can be heard. I've dreamed of seeing Eldergleam for years. Might I travel alongside you? I promise not to get in the way.
Yeah, come on.
I thank you for your kindness.
I hope I don't regret this. Come on.
Thank
this way.
The pain is already easing.
Yeah, I thought we would be able to, stop here, But okay, I guess this is the last step to retrieve the Elder Gleam sap. Where are we going now? Ooh, look at this. Wow, into regions that we have not yet explored. So what is the closest area? So the towers, I'm not sure if Morvunskar is closer. Oh man, we're gonna go here to these towers. See, even my fast traveling around the world only helps so much. Okay, looks like this one. Oh, here's my horse. Okay, cool. Oh man. Whoops.
Sorry about that. Forgot I had my bow. There we go. At least you don't hold a grudge.
Get him.
More. Can we just keep on our mission? Do we really have to go and fight these people? Out for these damn bandits. All right, let's go. Come on. We didn't come here to fight no bandits. What's this? A health potion? Yes. It's about time. You need a, like a sword or something. Can I give you anything, sir? Oh, apparently not. Okay, come on. So you don't even, you're not a mage or anything? You can't cast any spells? Oh, we going the wrong way. Back this way, folks. And I want my horse. Alright, I'm jumping down. Y'all catch up when you can. See, it's lots of stuff to discover here. Giant's camp right here. Alright, I don't want to engage. I hope these guys don't try to fight anybody. Come on. Let's just keep going. Oh, hell, there's a wolf. And those things just never leave you alone.
the horses don't vanish like they do in the Elder Scrolls when you go through water. It's nice. Oh hell, there's a giant standing right here. Two of them. Dragon, come on. Can't I just go on a quest without having to get in these drawn out fights and distractions? Okay, here we go. Elder Gleam discovered. Feeling this is not going to be easy. Looks like it doesn't want me to come through here.
What's on your mind?
Really? Oh my goodness, I cannot proceed any further. And that's where we need to go, right up there. Look at this, the game will not let me go further. Wow. Folks, I think we've been streaming here or recording for quite some time. I'm going to end the video here. And when we come back, hopefully I can figure out how to get up there and finish this quest. But I thank you all for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.